So a few months back, I picked up this 2003 Ford F-250 6.0 Powerstroke turbo diesel at auction, and it had a kind of a weird sound to it, a whistle, and it was missing some power at high RPM. I posted a video seeing what thoughts people had on it. I wasn't able to figure it out. I took it to a diesel mechanic, and he wasn't able to figure it out. And one day, I happened to be just hanging out here with a friend, kind of poking around at it, and we noticed that there was no coolant in this upper coolant hose, which seemed very strange to me because I had checked the reservoir many times, and there's plenty of pristine coolant in that reservoir. So we pulled the return lines on the reservoir. And much to our surprise, we found a healthy coating of RTV silicone blocking every single port to the reservoir. Now, why would a person do something like this, was the question. And the answer was quickly apparent. And that's because when you disconnect the upper radiator hose, we found an equally healthy dose of slurry in the tubes. There's oil in the coolant. So obviously this truck has some kind of problem with the oil cooler, the EGR cooler, head gasket. A head gasket seems pretty likely given the loss of power. It's tough to say. Sometimes an oil cooler can cause a head gasket failure, based on my research anyway. And I'm definitely not the kind of person that, you know, gets all fired up about something like this. But I gotta say, I've never seen anything like this before. You know, I've heard car salesmen saying crazy things, you know, oh, that check engine light, it's just because the detailer, you know, washed out the engine bay with a pressure washer, things that no one should really believe. But someone with the time and knowledge and attention to detail to mask this problem so well that I couldn't figure it out for a while, and nor could the diesel mechanic I took it to. I mean, that person obviously would have been able to fix this problem, but instead, you know, took their time and intelligence and used it to mask the problem instead of fixing it, and then, you know, pass it off to auction and take advantage of someone, which is really disappointing. But I was pretty blown away when I saw this. I've never seen a hack this good to take advantage of someone, and I just wanted to share that with you guys. Feel free to post your comments and let me know what you think, and if you want, I'll tell you what dealer I bought it from. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not that kind of person. But there you go. Watch out.